Hi, and welcome to Wilson Video Bulletin. I'm Chad.
And I'm Chad.
Second of two annual Blood Cross drives are March 16th. To donate, go ahead and meet with a Red Cross member or go to E3 to sign up. Donors must be at least 17 years of age, and if you're 17 years of age, you must have a parental consent. All donors must have a picture ID, so you make sure you have one of those. And the BSU with their activities on how they went this month, and a football meeting with Coach Oviedo. Coach Oviedo.
I'm here with the girls from BSU, and we're going to be talking about BSU. So what was your month of February like?
Our month of February was good. I appreciate everybody for coming and supporting us. We worked really hard, and I hope you guys enjoyed all our performances. So, yeah, it's good.
So, what was your guys' purpose of the bake sale on Friday?
For the bake sale on Friday, we're trying to raise money so that BSU could go on trips and do things, because our BSU hasn't been, like, up and running for the past couple of years, so we're trying to get that started again.
Were you guys happy with your guys' performance at the rally?
Yeah, so we're happy. Yeah. It was good. We worked hard, so.
Did you like it?
Yeah, it was real good.
That's good. Yeah, like hope everyone liked it. So, yeah.
Hi, my name is Coach Oviedo. I'm the head varsity football coach here on campus, and what you're looking at behind me is a highlight videotape of our 2003 season. The Wildcats had a very successful season this year. We recorded a 10-3 record. We made it to the CIF Division VI playoffs, and along the way we defeated a lot of good teams, teams like Charter Oak and Foothill, which made last year's CIF finals, and also Villa Park, which was undefeated going into our quarterfinal game this year. So we had a lot of success, and we'd really like to try to build upon that success this year. I'd like to announce an informational meeting for all students who are interested in going out for football this year, who are not currently within the football program. This meeting will be held this Thursday, March the 4th. It will be held in my room, room D6, during lunch. Right? And again, this is for players who are currently not within the program, who are interested in coming out for football. Why do it? Why participate in football? Well, first of all, I think it's fun. I think the guys have a really good time in the program. They enjoy being part of a real team concept, working together to achieve a common goal. We've been successful last year, so that makes it a lot of fun too as well. And we really want to build upon that success this year. It's challenging. I think that with challenge comes high rewards, and I think anything that's worth working towards can be very rewarding. We have a lot of good athletes here on campus who currently aren't playing football. We have a lot of kids who are playing basketball or soccer or other sports who really could add something to our program. I would like to extend a special invitation to them to attend this meeting and to see what to consider playing football and see what it's all about. So again, the meeting is scheduled for this Thursday, March the 4th. It will be held in my room, room D6, at lunch. Thanks a lot, and I hope you enjoyed the video.
If you want to join football, go ahead and do that. The Poetry Club is going to be going to the Bluebird Cafe in Whittier on Saturday, March 13th. If anyone is interested, please contact the lovely Miss Arcos and go ahead and go into room G6 for that. All right, and we have an ad for the Snackateria and the Word About. It's a talk show. Check it out. Hot chocolate.
Have you ever cheated on
Peso? Hey, so have you ever
cheated on you? Has anyone cheated on you?
Hey, what's up, everybody? My name's Albert. Welcome to my new show, The Word About. We're here with Jackie Price and Christina, and our topic today is cheaters. Have you been cheated on? And have you cheated on anybody? All right, let's talk to Christina first.
Sure.
What do you think about cheating, Christina?
I think it's fun. No, just kidding. I think it's wrong.
Why do you think it's wrong?
It hurts.
Have you ever cheated on anybody?
Sure, no. No, I haven't.
What about you, Jackie? Okay.
What
do you consider cheating? Do you have to be with the person? Do you have to be talking to the person? Does it have to be long? Like,
I think cheating is when just kissing and, like, you know, petting and rubbing.
Bryce, what about you? Have you cheated on anybody?
Yes, I have. It's a very vicious cycle, you know what I'm saying? I've cheated on people, and people have cheated on me, you know? That's how it goes.
Right. Did you enjoy cheating on the person?
Ooh. Yeah, at the moment, I'm not going to lie, you know. It's pretty fun.
Is her name in it?
No. All right, let's calm down.
Okay.
I don't know.
Let's go out and see what other people think about cheating.
So what do you think about cheating?
I don't think cheating's good. I personally haven't cheated on anybody.
It sucks. They should be hung by their toenails and beaten with their arms.
Yeah, I think it's bad. That's one of the things that I would never do.
If you don't get caught, do it.
Have you ever been cheated on, though?
No, I haven't.
Not that I know of. But I hypothesize. Some of you, I know what you do.
So.
I'm not going to name any names, but I know what they do.
You know how pretty I am? Anybody gonna cheat on me?
Not that I ever know of. I don't know. You never know.
Well, you know what? That's the show for this week. What a wicked game you play
to make me feel this. You're hot, sweet, and steamy. I love you.
Man, I want something hot and steamy. That does sound good, man. I want one right now. All right, the applications for the Scholarship Federation are now available for all classmen. The deadline is Tuesday, March 2nd at 12:25 p.m. on the dot. See Ms. Fosnims in the IB office ASAP. All right, and next we have Wrestling with Sam Choi recaps. Good job, guys. And Winter Sports Wrap-Up with Stephen Powell.
Hi, I'm here with two-time meet champ, Sam Choi. So, how did the season go?
We had a pretty good season. We finished off the season 6-5.
How were league finals?
At league finals, we had four league champs, Hiram Mraz, Matt Medina, Andres Campos, and myself.
Who qualified for the CIF?
We have Jimmy Quach, Shin Kamatsu, Matt Medina, Reed Pugh, Hiram Mraz, and Andres Campos.
And how did CIF go?
At CIF, we didn't do as well as we expected, but Andres Campos, our heavyweight, he almost placed in CIF. He beat the number 2 seed, and he almost made it to Masters.
And all the ladies are dying to know, how do you keep that weight of yours, and are you single?
I just watch what I eat, you know, eat Subways, no soda, and no comment on the single part.
All right, hello, and welcome to this week's sports update. I'm Stephen Powell. All right, girls soccer came in second place in league. Their first round CIF is on Saturday. Boys basketball had a record of 2-6 in league. Girls basketball, boys soccer were both 0-8 in league. Girls water polo came in third out of four teams. So congratulations to water polo. And also wrestling did not qualify for CIF as a team. But Sam Choi, he qualified. And also congratulations to Carolina and Natalie Hayes for first place all league in girls water polo. All right, good job. Applications for the California Scholarship Federations are now available to all grade students. The deadline is Tuesday, March 2nd at 12:25 p.m. on the dot. Don't be late. See Ms. Fosnes in the IB office as soon as possible.
Yeah.
All right, now we got question of the week with Little Miss. I'm going to get you back, Natalie Hayes.
Why do all superheroes wear spandex?
Because they like it.
Because they like it.
So they can show off all their muscles because they all work out a lot.
When they wear it, make them like, look cool and stuff, and you know.
It shows their height. It shows their packages and everything. It shows what they got.
A gentleman as flamboyant as myself wears spandex all the time. It keeps the muscular extremities close to it all the time, so you can make the most fraudulent boost you can in any direction you choose.
Because it feels good.
Why is Donkey Kong called Donkey Kong if he's a monkey?
Maybe he likes to, I don't know. This is a Hong Kong, that's why he named himself Donkey Kong and stuff.
His parents were donkeys. He's Donkey Kong because he's a monkey. His adoptive parent for donkeys.
He liked the name.
Because he's cool.
That's a very good question. I'll take that up with my study group, the Black Aphrodisiacs. We're located in the San Gabriel Valley. We meet from 7 to 8 every day.
People with big eyes see out of body range than with people with smaller eyes?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They see, like, behind their backs and all that.
People with big eyes see everything. That's a common misconception made by uncivilized people who are very ignorant to the things of today's common world.
Maybe they're seeing big things or something like that.
People with bigger eyes have smaller pupils. Thus.
And henceforth.
Yeah, because their eyes are bigger and they can see wider.
What does a teen t-shirt really mean?
I think it's mean, like, us, you know, like, teenager and stuff, like that, I think, yeah.
Tight, because a lot of t-shirts are tight and they cling to you, so yeah.
You see, the arms is like a little R, see, T.
Because the shirt looks like a T.
It's an abbreviation for the context of the word, t-shirt. You have to look beyond the word, t-shirt. Obviously, the T in t-shirt means that the shirt is shaped like a T.
Man, those are some good questions. They really made me think. Me too. The second annual Mr. Wilson High School will be held on March 11th. Tickets go on sale soon, so make sure you get them. Watch. Just wait, you can see. I'm going to win that thing. Watch.
Come on, Spencer. No, you know that.
I bet you I'll win so much. I'm better looking than you are.
Oh, I'm out of here.